This is part one of my work with this 3-year-old Frisian colt. He's only been at the barn for a couple of days, and I'm showing the beginning, sharing territory, getting to know him in the pasture. He settled in really well, and I think I'm reading Carolyn's blog here. As usual, I like to read it on my smartphone. So, this is the first step. It's nice for me as a trainer because I don't have to start working with him technically. I can build up, through using the waterhole rituals, I can build up a connection with him and get to know him. And what's really cool about them is that I can get to know him as a horse and, you know, let him shape my leadership so that when I do go to do the technical training, I have an idea of how to approach him in a way that will be agreeable to him. So this is really of great value to me as a trainer to be able to sit with them in this environment as long as I feel safe. And I was getting to know this horse and, you know, how, first of all, how he is in the world, you know, how he meets the world, which helps me as a trainer. Is he, you know, a skittish horse, a shy horse? Is he curious, gregarious, you know, dominant? Any of those things I can observe by how he interacts with the horses around him and how he interacts with me. So I don't show this ritual very often because it seems like there's not a lot going on, but I think it's important, and I decided to show it with him because he's brand new. And here, I'm just setting a little bit of boundaries with him as he investigates me, and I just ask him if he would not chew on the chair. I wouldn't mind him hanging out with me, but to not chew on things. And I want to see how he approaches me. This is all helping me get to know him just like I would a person or a new student. So I don't mind him checking me out. I like to feel his energy around me. He's not doing anything, you know, except for, you know, looking me over. He's getting to know me just like I'm getting to know him, see what I'm about. So in this work, it's really like learning about a new person. I see him just like someone else that I met for the first time. And I'm showing him that I don't have any agenda. I just want to get to know him out here and spend a little time with him. And if the opportunities come up for me to have a little bit of shaping of leadership, which he creates, then and so be it. But really right now, I'm just sitting and reading. And if he's interacting with me, I'm just observing how he interacts and not really wanting anything from him. So this really shows what sharing territory really looks like. It may look like I'm ignoring him even, and I'm not ignoring him, but the whole point of reading is that you don't really connect to the horse mentally. You just have a neutral kind of energy around the horse. So if he chooses to connect, it really is his own choice. And I'm not seeking him out in any way, so I'm occupying myself. So as I discover who this horse is, how he unfolds to me, and I literally had no knowledge of this horse. He came in on a referral, and he was recommended by a fellow trainer. Here I'm saying hello to him, so that's part of the second ritual. So I really didn't have anything to go on, you know, what his temperament was, but what his owner told me. And Yeah, so I'm really feeling like I start from square one with him because I like to just find out for myself who he is and his, who how he feels about the world around him. Fortunately, the weather was very nice. So it's nice when you're sharing territory to not have to deal with super cold or inclement weather. And he got sent to me in this nice spring that we're having, so that worked out nicely. So here, I noticed that he was at the hay pile, and so I decided to move my chair just over to where that was, just so I could hang out with him while he enjoyed his hay. Again, I want nothing from him here. Just hanging out with him. That's what sharing territory is about. But what a nice tool, as I said before, for a professional to have before we start having to have a real plan of technical training. And in the coming videos, you'll see how I start to address some technical things. In fact, the next video in the series, I'll explain how I'm starting to address some of the things that I saw initially when I first watched him come into the barn, and I saw what the owner would probably want addressed. So you can see how in the liberty phase you can actually start addressing things like manners and simple cues that the horse should understand, you know, like whoa and move over and sort of yielding to different requests. So remember, this is about being a lead horse, saying hello here. Again, took this opportunity, since you're close, to say hello a few times. That's building trust with him, letting him know that I don't really need anything from him, but I'd like to introduce myself. I'm Farah. And I don't know if I said his name, but it is say his name in the credits. Django is his name. And he just came over and introduced himself again here. What's nice about his interaction with me is already I'm feeling that he is a dominant horse, but he is not excessively dominant, and how he approached me was actually quite soft, and he did not really get, you know, rude or pushy, which is also nice. And I didn't even have to get up. I asked him, you know, a few times if he wouldn't chew on the chair, and he was fine about that. And I just, you know, made a suggestion with my hand. So these are things that tell me, you see me there. See, I just raised my hand and he said, oh, no problem. I won't chew on the chair there. So these are things that give me information about him, that he is, you know, not going to be difficult to move, or he doesn't feel like he wants to have any trouble about that. He said, no problem. No worries. I'll go back to eating my hay. So as a trainer, that's all valuable information for me. And it's also setting down, you know, how we're going to move forward, the two of us, together in our relationship and in our work together. So I did a lot of saying hello here. And again, the saying hello is about building trust and allowing him to, if he wants to give me permission to come into his space, I follow his rules, and if he allows me to come in and visit him and greet him, then I do, but I don't linger there. I just walk away as soon as he reaches out and says hello to me. So you see me do that several times here. He sees me coming this time. Now here, I paused because he's probably looking away. Yeah, he's looking away, so I'm waiting. I won't approach him until he gives me two eyes again, which to me is permission to come in. So now he's two eyes. You see him reach out and walk towards me, and again, I'm not petting him, I'm just walking off, but look what happened there after several hellos. He volunteered a companion walk completely spontaneously, all on his own there. And this is literally the first time I've sat with him. And it was a short one, but it was completely spontaneous. And then he left me there, and so I went back and sat down in my chair. So that was a pretty nice first meeting and first two waterhole rituals with him. Stay tuned for more.